Good morning. It is a early morning, 5:24, and I am already at Amber's house. Here she comes. Look who it is. Uh-oh, gotta let her in. Good morning. How are you?
Oh my God.
We are on our way to the airport. Excited?
Yes.
Okay.
Slightly tired.
Yeah, it's early. Why it's awesome to travel with Amber. Look what she did. She marked up the whole map with all the places that we want to go, where our hotel is in reference, when places are open, when they're closed.
I should sell these maps.
You really should. This is amazing. So, well, let me see the other one. Oh, this is the one about food.
And the FIT Museum.
Okay.
And restaurants.
Near us.
Near that, yeah.
Cute. Awesome. Made it to New Jersey. We flew into Newark and we are waiting for the train to take us into the city. If you've never traveled here before, it's a neat trick that you can get a flight into New Jersey and then take the train. The train's like $13 versus a cab from JFK or LaGuardia, which would be like sometimes $100. So it's not the most expedient way to get there. We have to wait like 30, 40 minutes for the train, and then the train will take another 30 minutes. But the good news is nothing's open yet. Like, we're not missing out on anything right now. The plan for today is the FIT Museum and Mood, and neither of those places open until 10 on Saturday. But we are also very hungry. We need our second breakfast because we both ate breakfast at 4:30.
Yeah.
At like 4:30, 5 in the morning. So it's basically like our lunchtime already. So we are slowly but surely making our way there, saving money for fabric because that's what's most important.
Priorities.
Yes. So we'll see. I've never done this train thing before. Or maybe I have one time, like a long time ago, and I just don't remember. None of this seems familiar. So it should be fun. The little airport air Tran that we took over here was already very exciting for us. Kind of felt like Disney a little bit.
Checking out all the dirty snow.
Yep, we saw snow for probably the first time in a couple of years. Neither of us have seen snow. It wasn't even falling, it was just frozen on the ground, like dirty and gross, but still snow to us. So, but yeah, it felt like a Disney ride in a way. Just because we're just not used to it. So the rest of the train ride should be scenic. I'm anticipating traveling through lots of neighborhoods, and I don't know. I don't really know what to expect. Yeah. So we shall see, but we are just waiting. There's like not a lot of people here. I don't know if that's normal or not. Maybe like a couple dozen of us, and that's it. But I wonder how close we were to catching the train before this one.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, did it just...
And if our first plane had been late,
yes,
maybe...
That's true. And we stopped to go to the bathroom, and we were in the very back of the plane, so we were the last ones to get off, and we had to check our bags, so we had to wait for that. So there's a chance we could have made the earlier train if we didn't have all of that. For sure we would have caught an earlier one. I just don't know how close it actually was. So
yeah, still have the whole day.
Yeah, still lots of time. I'm just mostly hungry.
Yeah.
I just really want to get... Our hotel has... They offer breakfast to the guests. And even though technically we're not a guest yet, we are hoping that they will let us have breakfast. Yeah, we'll just act... Did they ask for our, room number or anything?
This is a different hotel than the
rest of us. Is it? Gosh, I keep thinking it's the same one. They asked for a room number. I don't know what was either why. 813. Or so they'll be like, we don't have an 813.
Like, we'll tell you later.
Yeah. Can I get a rain check on that?
You just act like you know what you're doing.
Yeah, just walk in. Anyway, so yeah, that's the update for now. It is, what is it, 9? 9, almost 9:40. So, yeah. Check in soon. Well, we made it. We're here in the big city. We had a bit of an issue checking in. I had booked the reservation, but for some reason they put it under Amber's name. So there's like this whole thing, and he had to call the place, and all along all we had to do was give them Amber's name. But the good news is we got in at like 11 and they had our room ready. So we were able to go ahead and put our stuff in our room and kind of get freshened up and use the bathroom and of course check the Wi-Fi. So after we did all that, we are on our way to get some lunch. That is a priority. And then we are headed to the FIT Museum. So we have about maybe, half a mile walk?
Yeah.
So we're hoping to find some food along the way, because at this point we're starving. The whole train experience took a lot longer than we thought, probably an hour all in all. And then to walk to the hotel, for sure, a little more than an hour. So we are definitely hungry. It's past our meal time. We can't be getting hangry on our first day. So we're gonna go eat. So I would basically wear this in a heartbeat. It's only from 2015. It's like wax print and Oxford shirting. And then look at the quilting on this leather dress. So freaking cool. Isn't that awesome?
Oh wow. And when you told me how much they were,
this is the, what's it called? Black Fashion Designers exhibit? At FIT. So really pretty. Look at this one. The black is all hand beaded work. So cool.
Yeah. Did you get
Tina Turner's dress. Pretty. Super cool. At the FIT Museum, and now we are getting burgers. We're having second lunch because that's how we roll. We walked so much. We deserve. Yeah, I've already, like, at 11 o'clock this morning, I had reached my, like, exercise goal on my Apple Watch by 11. So, yeah, we did walk a lot. The FIT Museum's, like, 13 blocks or so from our hotel, maybe more, 15-ish. Anyways, so we worked up another appetite. So we're gonna share a burger and some fries now. But the FIT Museum was awesome. We had a really great time. I tried to get some video, but we kept getting in trouble for taking video, so I had to stop. So I got some pictures too, but it was really, really cool. The most impressive one was the Adrien exhibit. That guy's freaking master. Like, honestly, all the detail was so cool, so awesome. It was our favorite. Sorry, we had to order. Anyways, the Adrien exhibit was really, really awesome. It was my favorite part, although the Parisian fashion one was just really inspiring to look at because it's so iconic. They had the Mondrian dress there, which was cool, and just like a ton of really cool stuff from the 50s and 60s in Paris, which was awesome. Right? What did you think?
I loved it all. It was so much to look at. Now I'm like inspirational overload.
Yeah, we have a lot of, like, our brains are so full of imagery right now, and it's very inspiring to see all those things. The black fashion one was really nice, too.
Yeah, really impressive.
Yeah, it was really nice just to, I don't know, I never really thought of fashion being black or white or anything else. So I guess it was nice to see them being recognized.
New perspective.
Yeah, yeah, so it was really cool.
Okay, we made it to Mood. We have not been here since they redid everything, so we're gonna check it out.
So we got here and pretty much just went straight downstairs to the knits. And we are just looking around. They have so much to choose from. So I am trying to restrain myself and not buy everything I love and only buy the things that I really think I'm going to make, like, in the next few months. Unlike other trips where I've just bought everything. So we will see. I will show you as we find some things that we like. So I'm here at Mood. What's your name?
Becky.
Hey, Becky. And look, I got this fabric cut. And look, Becky made a bag.
Yeah.
So it was meant to be my first cut, and I run into Becky, and she was eyeing this other fabric that I'm going to get here.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Good so choice. I guess we have good, the similar taste.
Yeah. Good choice.
Same taste. Awesome. Thank you. Nice meeting you.
But this is, you know,
that is really pretty.
Plain and border.
Like a border
plain print? And border.
Yeah. It is? Okay. We're looking for a border print.
Yeah, let's see it.
1 second, okay?
We made it to Chic Fabrics. 229? 229 West 39th? Where are we?
239
West 39th Street. One of our favorite spots for affordable fabrics. We've already both found a cotton that we like. Amber's gonna make a shirt dress. And I found one for a pair of like shaitan chinos or some kind of shorts.
Yes.
And now we're trying to spot a knit floral border print. Is it awesome?
Look at this, Lindsay.
Hold it up more. Oh, that is really pretty.
No, that's good color. No, nice color. Mm-hmm.
It's pretty.
And it's $5 a yard, y'all.
And it helps my friend.
$5 a yard. This place is awesome. You always say you have to dig a lot to find what you want, but they give you a stool and they make it easy. And it's kind of fun. So they close in 40 minutes. We will see what kind of damage we can do. There's also these really cool laces that we like too, so maybe we'll get some of those. Stay tuned. Hey you guys, so we are back at the hotel. We left Chic and came back here for a minute to kind of regroup, put our bags down, and then we went and had dinner at this place called Room Service, which was like Thai food. I had their room service. You know, now that I think about it, I think she gave me regular pad thai. Mm-hmm. I don't remember it having mangoes in it. Oh no, but it was wrapped in that egg thing.
Yeah, it was the...
Anyways, I thought it was supposed to have mangoes in it and something, but I don't remember it having that. But the whole thing, if you ever had pad thai before, instead of it having like the egg inside, it was the whole pad thai was wrapped in this egg crepe thing.
Pad thai omelet.
Yeah, it was really cool. And then Amber had...
The Massaman curry?
Massaman curry.
It's really good.
Yeah, it looked really good.
And we had those curry...
And we shared some curry, fried curry something. So it was really good. There was a little bit of a wait. They quoted us like 25 minutes, but I feel like we sat down really quickly.
Yeah.
And the food came out really fast, so we were able to get back here. It is like 8:30, and we've been here for probably half an hour now, kind of like... Veg and I were both pretty tired, but we did want to show you a fabric haul because that's why we're here, right? So, as you know, we went to Mood and Chic.
Yes.
So, and we each got 3 fabrics, which is good for us. So, here's what we got. All right. So this is our Mood bags. This is mine. So this is a Swiss dot with this amazing navy and like bright yellow embroidery on it, basically. Look how gorgeous that is. Even the lighting in here isn't amazing and you can still see how vibrant those colors are. So I just love how geometric it is with the Swiss dot. It's just, I only got a yard. And I just want to make like a top with it. Maybe like a, oh, my brain isn't working.
What was that grain line?
Yes, the grain line.
With the dress.
Willow.
Willow, yes.
Grain line willow is what I'm probably going to make with this. It's pretty sheer too. So I've got to figure something out about that. But that's the first one. And then y'all met Becky in the store. It was so sweet of her to vlog with me. But we both got this. It was in the denim section. So I assume it's some kind of twill. But it's just a really pretty stripe. There's the right side of that. And it's like, it's got to be 72 inches wide. It's huge. So I just got 2 yards. And I'm going to make like a fit and flare dress. Maybe with some pleats for the skirt. Maybe play up the stripes a little bit. I don't know. So I know I was just telling you guys in the swatch video that I don't like evenly spaced stripes, but I guess there's an exception to the rule always. So this is it for me. And then Amber at Mood got this little guy.
Oh, heavy.
One little package. What is this?
I think it was a double knit.
rayon from Italy.
Italian rayon double knit, and the lighting again, yeah, not great.
Black with these big, like, abstract teal, like, rose flower thing.
Yeah, we did a little, like, impromptu test while we were there, because they had a purple one, a red one, and this one.
And of course I went with the teal.
So she ruled out the red pretty quickly, and then we held up the purple to her, and then held up the green, and as soon as she held up the green, I was like, yeah, this is it. This is the one. So
yeah, that'll be a really cute dress.
Yeah, she's thinking like a just real simple knit dress.
Sleeveless. Stretch, and it just feels amazing.
Yeah, it does feel really, really good. Yeah. It's a perfect weight double knit for Charleston, I feel like. Cool. Awesome. And then next is Chic with their I Heart New York bags, which are so cute. All right, mine is a, what is this, Ponte, and it's this,
Scoop-a-knit Ponte?
It said on the sign Ponte, but it does feel a little,
they're all mixed in,
okay. One,
it's got like that kind of neoprene,
spongy, yeah, but it's got this pretty cream background, and then these huge flower motifs kind of sporadically all over it. It's slightly sheer, so I'm probably going to do like a fuller skirt, fit and flare, maybe a circle skirt or something like that, but it's just really sweet and precious, and if I can get it done in time, I'll do it for the Easter.
That would be perfect for
Easter. The Easter, sew-along challenge thing that everybody's doing. I think this will be perfect for that. Mm-hmm. So, again, it'll probably be sleeveless, like Amber's, you know, really simple, just kind of let the fabric shine as it should. And then Amber got two from Chic.
Yes. Let's see. So they have amazing prices, and I picked up this. I think it's a poly spandex, like an ITY knit. Mm-hmm. Really stretchy. Really lightweight.
ITY for sure. Very lightweight. Yeah.
Crazy print, but it's like colors that I love, and it was like $4.99 a yard.
Yeah. It's kind of like an overall chevron stripe, but each layer of the chevron is different from the one before.
Yeah, it just said summer dress.
Yeah. So we were modeling it earlier as either like a waterfall type dress or a wrap dress or something
fitted in the bodice with
a gathered skirt. Yeah.
But yeah, something fun and summery.
Mm-hmm.
And the second one I got was this cotton sateen. I don't remember if it had stretch. It does have stretch. I was thinking a shirt dress. It's a little stiff right now, so it would be like a structured shirt dress, but it might soften up in the wash.
Yeah.
So we'll have to see. But I just love anything blue and anything floral.
And so blue, black, and white, I think, are Amber's favorite colors together.
Pretty.
Yeah.
So they've got that shirt dress challenge that's going on, I think.
Oh, okay.
It ends in June or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A couple people have started, so I've got several shirt dress patterns that I haven't sewn, so I really want to sew one up for the summer.
All good. Well, there you have it. That is day one for us in New York City. We're basically pooped. At this point, we are at 16 hours of being awake, and we're not going to be awake for much longer. I'm going to take a shower, wash my face. We have our matching pajamas. You'll get to see those in tomorrow's video. So we're going to put those on and pass out to HGTV probably. So yeah, thanks for following along. Hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye.